Breaking news, the three Americans held prisoner in North Korea and heading back to the U.S. right now. This is their plane in Alaska. Not long after they landed, we received a statement from the three, which reads in part, quote, "We would like to express our deep appreciation to the United States government, President Trump, Secretary Pompeo, and the people of the United States for bringing us home. They have been held captive in North Korea from between a year and 2.5 years. And they are now set to land in just a few hours in Washington. That is where the president and the first lady will meet them personally in the early hours of tomorrow morning. Out front now, Laura Ling. She spent 140 days in a North Korean prison, accused of illegally entering the country. She and Una Lee were pardoned after former President Bill Clinton flew there and met with Kim Jong-il. I mean, I just, you know, Laura, today, thinking about you and, you know, how you must feel looking at this moment, you know, reliving what you endured and went through in that homecoming. You've been on that plane heading home. You were there for almost 5 months, about 5 months in a North Korean prison. I mean, what do you think is really going through these three Americans' minds tonight?
Well, Erin, I think that they are ecstatic. I think that they're relieved. And I think there's probably a little bit of disbelief because let's not forget that just a few months ago, the United States and North Korea were threatening to annihilate one another. And so I can only imagine that they were scared out of their minds because they probably felt that their fate was in some ways connected to the geopolitical situation. And for them to now be finally coming home, reuniting with their families, I mean, I'm sure that they are just overjoyed. I got chills listening to you read their statement.
I mean, it is just, I mean, you know, for any of us, impossible to imagine. You, though, of course, know. You can feel what it's like. I mean, what was your trip home like, that long trip with the stops and everything that you went through?
You know, it was incredible, and I'm so eternally grateful to President Clinton and his team for embarking on that very unpredictable journey to North Korea to retrieve us. But walking down the steps of that plane, seeing my family, being able to embrace them, you know, I definitely saw how my parents had aged because they had worried about me so much, and that was really heart-wrenching. It was hard to deal with some of the media attention, and so I hope that these three Americans are able to have, you know, the peace and privacy that they deserve to really reconnect with their family and catch up.
And you know, I know when you were there, obviously, you were so isolated from the world. I mean, how did you find out you were going to be going home? How did they break that news to you as we try to imagine what happened with these three men?
Yeah, well, there had been a lot of discussions. You know, I was engaging with my captors to try to figure out what was necessary to get us home. And I was told that a very important envoy had just touched down in Pyongyang and that if his visit went well, we would get to go home. And if it didn't, we would not get to go home. I was told that it was someone that I'd requested. And I had actually asked and requested that President Clinton serve as the envoy. And he so graciously accepted.
How long did it take for you to feel like you were finally free?
Oh, man. You know, I think that there are little things that I came to appreciate so much, that things that we take for granted, even things like music, taking a walk on the street, seeing the stars at night became little treasures for me. And they're things that we don't really think about. And I don't think I ever felt as strongly as I do or did about the value of freedom. So that's something that I just hold dear, you know, now more than I ever have before.
So beautifully said. Now, you know, according to the official North Korean news agency, Laura, President Trump requested Kim Jong-un release these three Americans. Some say Trump deserves the Nobel Peace Prize for what he's doing with North Korea. And Trump actually spoke about that this morning.
Do you deserve the Nobel Prize, do you think?
Everyone thinks so, but I would never say it. You know what I want to do? I want to get it finished. The prize I want is victory for the world, not for even here. I want victory for the world, because that's what we're talking about. So that's the only prize I want.
Laura, do you think he deserves the Nobel Peace Prize?
Well, I'm not going to answer that question. You know, that's up to a committee. But I do think that what is being lost in this conversation is human rights. So we have heard very little about the egregious human rights abuses that are taking place in North Korea. And I hope that in conversations going forward, this becomes part of the dialogue and that North Korea can be convinced that a path forward for truly lasting peace is to release its political prisoners and to allow its people to have the freedom that they so rightly deserve.
All right. Thank you very much. And thanks for your time.
Thanks, Erin.